I've made a copy of ODB13 pattern field and named this one ODB14 form properties. In an earlier video, I mentioned that there are times when we want our table name to start with TBL, then have our table name. I want to do that with our employees table, so I'm going to click on Tables in our database window and right-click on our employees table, rename, and put in the name TBL employees. Clicking OK. Now let's go to our forms. I'm going to double-click and try and open up our form employees. And we get an error. The data content could not be loaded. There exists no table named employees. And that's correct. We renamed our employee table. I'll click OK. I'm going to close this and reopen it in edit mode by right-clicking and selecting edit. Down on our form control toolbar, we've got something called form. If I click that, it opens up our form properties. We see this is our main form. If I go into data, we see the content type is table and the content says employees. We need this to say TBL-employees. To do that, I'll click this drop-down arrow and there's our new table name. I'll select that. We'll go down into design view. And we see all the data just how we left it in the last video. I'm going to go back into edit mode and clicking back on our form. There's a few other things on this form properties that I want to look at. Right here at the bottom, we have something called sort. If I click the dot, dot, dot icon, it brings up the sort order. We have last name ascending, first name descending. This is the exact sort we set from the navigation toolbar a few videos ago. So we can do that from the form properties as well as the form navigation toolbar. If we go up a little bit, we see something called filter. If I click on this dot 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 box, we see something called filter. This is the same filter that we saw in our form navigation toolbar. So we can set it here as well. I'm going to cancel out of here. Looking at these top three, we have allow deletions, allow additions, and allow modifications. We saw these same fields when we were creating our form with the form wizard, only these were checkboxes. If I change all these to no, we'll be able to view the data, but we wouldn't be able to delete anything, we wouldn't be able to add anything, or make any modifications to data that is there. The last one I want to point out here is this add data only. Changing this to yes would allow us to add records, but not view them at all. If you remember back in our form wizard, we had a radio button to choose the options of these three or just this add data only. It works the same way here, just without the radio button. Down on our form design toolbar, we have something called the form navigator. This is different than the navigator up at the top of our page. The form navigator does basically the same thing, only just for our form. We can see here everything that we put on the form. And since we gave them all proper names, we can click on something like label gender, and we see that that's selected. Maybe zip code. Down here, our text box zip is selected. If I right click on this, we can cut, delete, rename this property, or bring up the properties dialog box. I'll move this over. Now with the properties dialog box open, when I right click again, it's not available. We can also get to the form properties box here by clicking on main form. Now if I click on something like our text last name, we see that that's selected, and I right click, we have something else called replace with. Now, if I come down here to pattern field, I could replace my last name text box with a pattern field text box. If I did it this way, it will hold all that same formatting. In the previous video, and I had to reset the border to 3D, the background to gray 10%, and the height. And I can also do that right from the form itself. I can hold down Control, select first name. We see it gets selected on our form navigator. Right clicking, and they have replace with. Now, the reason I didn't do this with the pattern field was when I tried it, I didn't find it as effective as if I deleted it and re-added it. And I'm using LibreOffice 4.1. It may be a bug, or it may just be the way that that feature works. That's about all I'm going to say about the Form Navigator at this point. We'll become more familiar with it in the future when we start to work with multiple tables and subforms. I'm going to close this. I want to save my form and close that. I also want to edit my other form. I'm going to open up my form properties, go into data, change my content from employees to table employees. Closing that, saving that form, and saving my database.